It's our story. Harriet McBryde Johnson. Presented by the ADA Legacy Project. An Olmstead story from South Carolina, part 6 of 29.
A fairly recent development that was significant here was the Olmstead Supreme Court decision. And there was this organizing going on around the country around the fact that the attorney generals of various states had signed on to a brief saying basically that states ought to be allowed to confine people in institutions who don't want or need to be there. And a lot of us found that to be a pretty outrageous position. The court was being asked on the other side to rule that institutionalization is segregation, and segregation, last time I looked, was discrimination, and that discrimination violates the ADA. So that was the issue, and a lot of attorneys general were on what we thought was the wrong side of that. And South Carolina's attorney general at that time was a man named Charlie Condon, who was very, very famous as an advocate of states' rights on a variety of questions. And in fact, a lawyer friend of mine with Supreme Court connections said that, you know, the high-powered federalism lawyers called the most extreme states' rights position Condon-esque, you know, that he had his own adjective. And so a small group of us took it upon ourselves to basically give Charlie a hard time about being on the wrong side of that brief. And we got a meeting with some of his people, again, doing it the inside way, and we made our pitch, and we were politely heard, and, you know, it was clear that we were going to get blown off. We'll get back to you. Thank you for sharing your views, blah, blah, blah. And I got a wild hair, and I said, well, we need to know by day after tomorrow, because I'm having an event at the state capitol, and I need to know what to say about the attorney general. I had no plans to do that, but having said that, I went and took out a permit, and he wound up pulling off the brief the next day. And it was like 2 days before the oral argument, and I would like to think that the justice is getting a letter that this position was too extreme, even for Charlie Condon. I would like to think that that made a bit of a difference. And we went ahead with our event that I had taken out the permit for, and there was a lot of discussion. Well, what do we say about Charlie? And it was, the consensus was, well, he did the right thing. Let's don't embarrass him. Let's don't say anything. And so we had a rah-rah Olmstead event where we talked about the issue. And I remember the consensus was that we should not call it a rally, because rallying on the state capitol is what, you know, the rabble do. So it was it was an outdoor meeting, I think it was, you know. So it was a meeting with, you know, loudspeakers and signs and everything you would associate with a rally, but not a rally. And it was a very nice thing as it happened. And when the court did ultimately rule the right way, we were able to build on that strange little event and pull some people together. And the governor appointed a task force on home and community-based services, which ultimately issued a report, not a plan, but a report that included people with disabilities who had real-world experience. And that was a better document than it would have been. And if implemented, would do some good. But all of that was, a real opening, because it started with a bit of a victory. And it brought people together with the idea that what we want is not crazy. The Supreme Court agrees with us. How radical can it be? And, we we definitely, you know, haven't realized anything like, I mean, not even 10% of the potential. But I think the Olmstead case is one that we should remember in our history.
Does Mikasa blend with Olmstead?
And I'm really not familiar with the current incarnation of Mikasa. I don't know what that means at the moment, but as originally conceived, Olmstead goes beyond Mikasa to create a general right rather than carving out a percentage of the long-term care budget. I think Olmstead gives us a hook to say, you know, we don't want 25% of the long-term care budget. We want it all. That's what we should be saying. We want it all to serve people where they want to be. And so, I mean, it's pretty powerful stuff, and it has the seal of approval from a very conservative Supreme Court, so that's cool.
Be inspired. Be informed. Be involved. We plus you equals power, passion, pride. The It's Our Story Project is a national effort to make disability history public and accessible. Visit us at www.itsourstory.com or the It's Our Story Project YouTube channel.